The new Mule 610 is a new rendition of the older 550 Mule. Now, the 550 had a lot going for it. It was a great-sized machine that was small enough to fit in the back of a full-sized pickup truck. But the bad news was that it was just underpowered. Way underpowered. The new 600 solves that problem. Where the 550 had a rather anemic 286cc engine, the new 600s are powered by a 400cc air-cooled single-cylinder four-stroke. Compared to the two-wheel drive 600, the four-wheel drive 610 has an even more powerful output, as the engine has been outfitted with an improved intake and exhaust systems, along with higher compression. Whatever the modifications, and without pitting them in a side-by-side drag race, the 610 feels every bit as fast as the much heavier 3010. The power is transmitted to the drive wheels through a continuously variable transmission. The 610's transmission gives you a choice of low range, high range, neutral, and reverse. Just like the bigger 3010 mules, the 610 also lets you choose between four-wheel drive and two-wheel drive, as well as having the rear differential locked or unlocked. Also, like the bigger mules, the parking brake is an easy-to-reach and easy-to-use hand lever on the driver's left side. And unlike the bigger mules, hey, do I hear trumpets sounding? Okay, I'll do it. The 610 will start in gear with the brake on. You know, that's big, big news. And here's why. In typical work duty, a utility vehicle moves forward a ways and then stops. Now, rather than having to find a foot pedal to operate the parking brake, the mule operator can just reach down with her left hand as they are coming to a stop and give the parking brake a quick pull, then climb out to do the chore. Then, climbing back in, just release the parking brake with your left hand, put your foot on the brake pedal, and with the transmission still in the same exact gear that you left it in, start it up and move to the next stop. If you run your rig at work that requires a lot of stopping and starting, there's no system that's better. Not the bigger mules that must always be put into neutral, nor the Ranger that needs a parking brake applied by foot and released by hand. Although not quite as smooth operating as the V-twin and the big mules, the new 400cc four-stroke is plenty smooth. And it's quick enough that it's governed for a top speed of around 25 miles an hour. Now, Kawasaki says that the government requires that utility vehicles be governed, but evidently, the government only requires Kawasaki utility rigs to be governed, as seems like no one else does it. But whatever the reasons, the 610 would probably run out of suspension at higher speeds anyway. Besides, it is designed for work, and very few work sites, farms, or hunting leases require high-speed ability. In fact, to quote a friend of mine that runs a large tree farm, if you're smiling, you're going too fast. The 610 can tow up to 1,100 pounds on its optional hitch, and it can haul up to 400 pounds in its dump bed. Now, although still not as easy to dump as a Polaris Ranger, unlike the long bed of the Trans Cab or even the regular mule, the 610 can be dumped if not loaded too heavy. Now, although the 610 is longer than the old 550 by about 4 inches, at 52.5 inches wide, 107 inches long, and 71 inches tall, it'll still fit into the bed of a real pickup truck. And at just under 1,000 pounds, it shouldn't even make it squat. The 610 is built mostly from steel. Steel frame, steel bed, and steel floor underneath your feet. That gives it a quality feel. It also benefits from plenty of rubber bushings in areas like the tailgate that, although require more effort to latch, don't rattle while traversing rough terrain. Climbing aboard, the seating area provides plenty of room for two full-sized adults, and if everyone's been hungry for days, very friendly with each other and doesn't mind being crowded, I suppose you could even squeeze in a third person for a short distance. The engine and transmission operation is smooth and the suspension rather compliant if the going is neither too rough nor too fast. And perhaps the biggest benefit of the 610's small size is how easily it maneuvers around in tight places. And unless maximum capacity is your main requirement, most utility users are looking for something that can fit into small areas. Another benefit of the 610 is its price. The suggested retail price for the 600 two-wheel drive is $58.99. And it's $7,099 for the four-wheel drive 610 like our test model. While certainly not cheap, that's a big savings over the competition. Even the full-size Mule 3010 retails for $87.99. So with a little math, it's pretty easy to figure that that's either $1,800 left in your pocket, or if you're anything like me, that gives you what you'll need for a lift system, a top, a plow, wheels and tires, and a stereo. Well, okay, maybe not all that stuff, but you get the idea. Now, you may be looking at that small bed saying, that'll never work for me. Well, let me say that I've already looked at just how easy it'll be, how easy it would be, to remove the stock bed and install a little bit longer flatbed on the back. And another advantage of that longer bed would be that it would change the leverage of the swivel and make it easier to dump. But that's just me talking, and you know how I like to modify things. So, what do you get? Seating capacity for two, a small bed, maneuverability in tight places, and a lower price. The drawbacks? Well, it's not the people mover that the Transcab is. It's not the workhorse the standard Mule 3010 or the Polaris Ranger are, nor is it the fun runabout that the Rhino is. But maybe, like Goldilocks, you might find that the 610 is just about right. The good? Sturdy steel construction. Small size with great maneuverability, start in gear ability, and that handbrake, plus a great price. The bad? Small load capacity, limited suspension, and limited speed. The bottom line? The 610 might just be the right size utility vehicle for your needs. Not too big, not too much.